So last time we briefly discussed about travelogue. So I'd like to continue the same topic, unit one, travelogue. So I'd like to simply ask Mr. Gaurav Babu Shrestha. Gaurav Babu Shrestha, if you are listening to me, would you please tell me very briefly about travelogue and the points we should while preparing a travelogue?
Travelogue is a diary where we write when we are going somewhere. It is like a journal.
Wow, wonderful answer you have given. It's okay. So, my dear children, let me continue the same thing, okay? A memorable journey from Tarai to the hill. This is a travelogue. This is included in your textbook, right? So I'm going to share my screen. If you have any confusion, you have to please make queries and I will satisfy as much as possible. Okay, so we are going to discuss about a memorable journey from Tarai to the hill, right? So let's begin. When we are talking about a travelogue or whatever the writing or whatever the composition, we have to consider certain vocabs. We may find the typical words used in that type of writing, right? Any types of writing, there are certain words. Similarly, here I have picked up some words that could be taken under consideration while preparing a travelogue or a journal or journey diary, okay? So here I have given the meanings as well as the words. My dear students, I'm not going to discuss about these words. If you have any confusion there, you may ask me, right? But I won't spend the time explaining the words here, right? There are certain words. Just I will show and click, okay? So look at these words, how these words are used here and what's their meaning. Meaning as well as words I have given, right? So if you want time, you can copy. But if you need time, please tell me. I'm simply showing you the words first. These are the words used in this journey, or these are the words which are basically selected to describe the writer's journey from Tarai to the hills. I think you people have seen some new words there, right? Just there is a one cluster, right? Cluster. So these words might be familiar to you. Destination, garland. So I'm a little bit quicker. Here is a word, paying guest, right? What type of person is called paying guest? The person who lives in someone's or someone else's house and pays for food and accommodation. See, that type of person is called paying guest, right? And then there is another word, hospitality. This word is very much popular these days because most of the people look for the hospitality. Hospitality is one of the service. See the things, particularly provided to the guests. When we receive the guests, when we welcome our guests, how we behave, we have to behave them politely and with a good manner, that we call hospitality. See, there is one word, homely, right? That is a word, homely. Homely a word that sounds, you know, like a home. The environment that we feel at home. And if similar environment is felt wherever we go, that we may call homely, right? Homely environment. See, now the journey begins. Do you see the picture there? Look at the picture. This picture shows the plain area of Tarai, right? This picture shows the plain area of Tarai, and Tarai region is the breadbasket of our country. It has large area, not only large area, large fertile area, right? So most of the people farm different kinds of crops there, and they produce and supply for us. And here is the gate. You might have seen this gate. Why have I chosen this gate? This gate I chose because the journey begins from Birganj, right? I've written there, Birganj, Parsa. Birganj is the city, one of the major city of our country. See the thing, right? This is adjoined to India, right? This is adjoined to India. You could see here, this is the gate, okay? So the journey of the writer begins from this place to Kalegaon. Kalegaon is the beautiful place, one of the heavenly spot, one of the most beautiful place of our country, right? And that is one of the very, very attractive place for the tourist. It attracts many tourists, right? So this journey begins from Birganj and reaches to the Kalegaon. And see the things. Destination of this journey is, right? Destination of this journey is up to Kalegaon. Kalegaon lies, or Kalegaon is located in Lamjung district. Lamjung is very, very historical place. You might have heard that King Drobbe Saha, who was from same place, right? That place. And there was the system in the past to nominate the king by a game, especially Ghale people, right? They used to party, and the winners used to be nominated as the king there. So Drobbe Saha won that race and founded Gorkha state. So this is historical place, and mostly Gurung people reside there. Gurung people dwell there. See the things. And then, as I already told in my previous class, first person pronoun should be used in travelogue. When we prepare travelogue, we use the first person pronoun. So writer here used the pronoun I. See the things. So how did the writer mention that? I had heard that Kalegaon was really beautiful place for homestay. See the thing. I've already given you the meaning of homestay. If you noticed that slide back, you would get the word again and you could find the meaning too. So writer's parents made a plan to visit Kalegaon. They made 5-6 days plan. See the thing? And during her vacation. Vacation also, I made the word there, right? Vacation means the period. When you are given leave, shortened period. See the thing? So then the writer's journey from Birgans begins for Kalegaon. See the things. This is another part. Look at there. I have selected these two pictures. One is the picture of the Poon there. One is the picture of the Tarai people. And I have not selected bus, tractor, car, jeep, or truck. But I have selected this, look, bullock cart. This is also one of the part of or means of transportation used in Tarai region, but not in hilly and Himalayan region. See the thing? So I have chosen this picture. So from this place to that place, the writer sees or finds different kinds of experiences. The writer gains different kinds of experiences. Out of that experiences, this travelogue is prepared. See the thing. From there, we can go. Though I have written here, from Kathmandu, Pokhara, Birgans, Dang, you know, or we can use Dhangadi, Mahendranagar, whatever the places, whatever you know, right? From there, we can reach there by bus, right? And then I have also given that in that travelogue, you have to mention the means of transportation. How could we reach to that place? So I have given this. Look, and Besi Sahar is the place, right? That is the place which is the gateway to Kalegaon. In fact, we remember, we think, we believe Besi Sahar is the gateway to Kalegaon. And we reach to Besi Sahar. And after Besi Sahar, we have to walk on foot. Or we can take jeep. See the thing? If we walk laboriously, then our laborious walk might take 6 to 7 hours or 5 to 6 hours. It depends on our walking speed. If we take jeep, then it might take 2 to 3 hours or 3 to 4 hours. It also depends on the speed. See the thing? And then mostly Kalegaon would be a very much beautiful place and very much attractive place to visit during spring season and autumn season. But we can visit that place anytime you like or anytime we like. That is the time frame also. See the thing? I've given this information. I have told you that you need to give some important information, right? And basically, when we make a journey or when we plan to make a journey, we have to prepare the things on the basis of the information regarding that particular designated place or regarding that designated place. So we have to be very much careful about this. So look at this. I have given information clearly. 5 to 6 hours laborious walk from Besi Sahar or 3 to 4 hours by bus, jeep, motorbike. See the thing? Basically, we have to take, if we are unable to walk, then we have to take the vehicles. If we are able to walk and if we enjoy walking, then we have to go by the vehicles. and then look. This is the picture, and this bus might reach there or might not reach. See the thing? At least I have selected the attractive picture of the bus. So, and then one side you could see the people walking there. They are walking, and this light by bus. We have the option done. This option is available. And this is the roadway to Ghalegaon. We are here in Kathmandu, Pokhara. And here I have just shown you this. And this is Ghalegaon. Look, you could see here, right? From Kathmandu, you can go here. I have selected this map because most of the students are there. So I have selected this, right? And then we have to go to Ghalegaon here. And we have to take this route. And this is here, 2400 meter, you know, this is the altitude or height from the sea level, right? Here in this map, it is written 2400 meter. See the thing? Then, this is the beautiful picture of Besisar. When we reach to the Besisar, we have to stand there, right? We have to take rest there, and we enjoy the life there. This is one of the wonderful part. And when we reach there, the panoramic beauty of Besisar really tempts every visitor. Whoever visits there will get enchanted with the beauty of Besisar. This is Besisar. So these things we can observe there. We can have the beautiful scene. And when we reach there, the writer made the, you know, list of the experiences. Just the writer found the beautiful scene, the beautiful scenery, right? And writer spent one night at a hotel there in Besisar. And next day, they started their journey on foot. The journey, they started from there. While walking, they got tired and they broke their journey. Broke means here, they stopped their journey and took rest at Chautara in Baglungpani. This is one place, right? And they took rest there. After the rest, you know, they moved on to visualize, to see the beautiful mountain range. We can observe Mount Kanchenjunga, Mount Annapurna, Mount Machhapuchhre, Mount Manaslu. Mount Manaslu. So these are the beautiful mountain ranges that we could observe from Ghalegaon. So this is, wow, really very, very beautiful and attractive, exotic beauty of Ghalegaon. Look, this is one of the beautiful places. When we reach there, we really find the heaven. We experience the heavenly pleasure there. And these are the houses. These houses are constructed. See the thing? These houses are constructed for home stay, right? And the people there, they live, right? And then in these houses, the guests are received. See the thing? The tradition, the culture of Gyabre Gurungs, the Gurung people, they welcome the visitors there. They welcome and they manage the accommodation and food of their own choice, right? Means villagers or those people or local people, they really, really pay homage to us. They show their gratitude, and they are very, very humble, and they are very polite, and the way they behave, the way they welcome us really makes us feel that we are the one family member of them or one family member of that village. And these are the ranges. Look, I have shown the beautiful range that we could see. We could have the beautiful scene. We can visualize these things. So this is the information about that, right? Talegaon actually is situated, right? In that map, there was 2400 meter shown, but actual height from the sea level is 2070 meter. And this majestic village, this exotic village is not so far. It's just 205 kilometer from Kathmandu and 125 kilometer northeast from Pokhara. And Ghale people, especially Ghale women, they use different kinds of cloths, uniforms, attire, you know, use Ghale, Lungi, Kachar, Baku, etc. Since this place is highly populated by Ghale people, and their food item is especially they eat dal, bhat, tarkari, and achar. And they celebrate Losar festival. See that this is the Ghale woman. This is the picture of Ghale woman. Right? And this is the food item served to the guests unless they take themselves. Right? And then they have different cultural practices. They show Gantu dance, Jhakri dance, and Lama dance. See the things. And Krishna Charitra, these are the performances. They perform to welcome their guests, to entertain their guests. And these performances are shown there. And basically, they have the different kinds of lifestyle, you know, and their jobs and occupation. If we talk about that, their main occupation is farming, agriculture. Besides that, homestay is one of their business. So in homestay, what is the tradition? Actually, what is the tradition is the people there find the elder people, the oldest people, to put on tikka of rice to the guest, to welcome the guest. This is what they find. And this is farming. Under the farming, they have different things. And most of them, they have the job. Their job, basically, the people there, they join army, force line. You know, Indian Army, British Army, Nepal Police. This is the job side. And this is how the people from Ghalegaon, we get different things and different ideas. And my dear students, this is time. So I have completed my presentation. See the thing? This is what I'd like to share with you about that memoir, about that diary that was prescribed in our English book. And how many of you enjoyed this class? Please show me your hand up. Wow, great. It's my pleasure. And then if anybody has confusion, please you may raise your hand. If not, then I would begin.
Excuse me, sir, we have 5 minutes.
Okay, so I want to go to the chat. Then I have seen a picture is not clear. Admin, can please. Okay, you'll get this video in the YouTube too. And because of network problem, might be picture might not have been shown clearly. You'll get it properly. Okay, I will share it in your link too. Individual students link too. This slide will be shared to you. Don't worry. Right? So I'd like to ask a question to Miss Priyasna Shrestha. Priyasna Shrestha, could you please tell me what is the altitude of Ghalegaon from the sea level?
From the sea level?
Yes.
2,070 meters.
Wow, excellent. Wow, great. Great answer. Great answer. So, Mr. Sangam Bhandari, could you tell me the major occupations of Ghale people?
Indian Army, Nepal Army, Nepal Police Army, sir.
That is one part, Army. Other occupation? Major occupation. Okay. Mr. Abhushan Basnet. Abhushan Basnet, you could tell the major occupation of Ghale people.
Agriculture, farming.
Exactly. The main occupation is agriculture. Besides that, they do have business too. And they have job also, right? So, Sonisa Karki, could you please tell me how can we reach to Ghalegaon from Kathmandu?
Sir, by vehicles.
By vehicles and?
By walking.
By walking. Very good. Very good. We go up to Beshi Shahar by vehicles and we walk from there, or we may take jeep too. That's fine. So very quickly, I'd move to this Asmin Thapa. Asmin Thapa, can you tell me the attires of Ghale people?
They were like Tamang dress and...
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. You'll have assignment. Thank you very much. My dear students, you took the class. Please be connected in my next class. Thank you very much. Thank you, everyone. Goodbye. Have a good day.
All the materials, sorry, they hon bogus. All materials say gold class mein rakhti nuncha sorry, na. Ani baki ki problem dekhi ko sir, tujhe aba YouTube mein ekshil fill hai dinu alai na. Yeh se tablo alikati clear bani dekhne sa kuncha, right?